Hello everyone, it's your favorite engineer, and today we're gonna install an artificial intelligence model locally on your PC. So just forget about the ChatGPT, you will have your own on your own PC. And we start from downloading the Python and installing it. It will take a couple of minutes. This is essential for the AI launchers to start. Just let me do it. You go through the normal default settings and then it starts to install. You just click and forget. It takes a while to have it set up. Agree on all of the settings. Let's now check if you have the Python installed. Yeah, it is here. Of course, you get the Python from this page. And now we need some launcher for the AI models. There is one that is named Text Generation Web UI. This is a set of launchers that will allow you to run different models. And first you need to download and unpack it. So you go to install, download the repository. Here it is. What I will do, I will unpack it to my one of my directories on the second drive. I will first copy it. Let's make some directory here, maybe like AI. Now I will unpack it. So you see it is here. Once you have it, you go into the directory. So first you need to, you know, launch the CMD. So CMD, possibly as with the administrator rights. So like this. Now you go to the place when you have it downloaded. In my case, it will be drive D. Dir means print the directory. Now you go inside the directory like this, and then you have a script which is named start Windows bat, and you run it. It will now download necessary packages for the PuTTY and all of it. So you need to be patient. It takes a while. Okay, as you can see, this tool, this text generation web UI, doesn't support AMD on Windows yet. So I need to select that I have no graphic card, so I will do the model running only on the CPU. It's now installing the PyTorch. And once it is completed, I will be able to download and run a model. So it will take a while. Once the script downloaded all the files, it launches the web UI. You can see the link over here. So it is a local host and the port number 7860. I will now try to access this via browser. So let me do it. It's like this. You can see the web UI is now working, but it is not all. You need to download the model and run it. So once you have it, it will be visible over here. To do this, you need to go to the hugging face. That's the portal that is collection of all the models. And I personally recommend to download from this guy. So this guy has a plenty of, I would say, converted models that can operate on some pool-powered hardware. And what I'm doing at the moment, I'm downloading a particular type of a model. It is a newest llama, and it is, I would say, shrinked to fit on my PC. So let me show you the page. This guy has a lot of models. So once it is downloaded, you need to place it in some specified directory. So if you go to the to your directory when you have unpacked all the web UI, you will have a directory named models, and you need to put the model file into the, this directory, okay? So once it is downloaded, I will put it here and show you how it works. Okay, as you can see, I have downloaded the model and I placed it in this directory named models. So it is over here. And now I will try to refresh the web UI to see if it sees the model, and it is visible here. Right now, before you start to run it, I would suggest to play with some parameters. I would now change some values. This is NGPU. I do not have a GPU for this, but let's try to run it like this. And now let's place the load. It is now loading the model. You can see all the details over here. So in theory, it is running. Let's see if it is working. There were no errors. Let's now go to the chat window and ask the model some questions like, "Hello, Mr. Computer Man. What is 2 plus 2? And generate." It is now thinking. And oh, he's alive. So as you can see, even though I'm not using the GPU, it is working as a charm. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Now I have my computer man on my PC and I can ask him a question like, write me a code in Python . Interesting question, Mr. Computer Man. You see, it is very smart. It can add 2 plus 2. Okay, I hope you as impressed as I am, and I recommend you to download and play with it yourself. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope to see you again. Please subscribe button. Thank you very much. Bye bye.